Hi, my name is Joe. I'm a naturalist at Trailside Nature and Science Center, and today Trailside travels to Conant Park for a winter exploration.
Hi everyone, my name is JD. I'm a naturalist at Trailside Nature and Science Center.
Hi everyone, my name is Roslyn, and I'm also a park naturalist at Trailside Nature and Science Center.
For this video, Trailside is traveling to Conant Park in Hillside, right behind Kane University and right in between Conant Street in Hillside and Wilder Street in Union.
Sitting on top of the Elizabeth River, Conant Park was designed by the famed Olmsted brothers. They envisioned an emerald necklace for the Union County Park System, which also included Passaic River Park and Rahway River Park.
Within the park, you can find traditional hiking trails along the Elizabeth River and the newly installed multi-use trail, a rubberized 1.1-mile looping walkway providing comfortable, even ground. During the winter season, there are many changes in nature. The days get colder and shorter, and plants and animals have to adapt in order to survive. Animals will slow their activity and rest more. To ensure they have enough nourishment, they may store food or bulk up. To save water and energy where they can, trees and plants shed their leaves once it gets cold. Water is no guarantee in winter. It is more often than not ice. In winter, a blanket of snow acts as insulation. It protects the ground and tree roots, and it also provides cover for small animals to burrow under, such as mice. For animals such as rabbits, snow provides a stepping stool to reach new branches and sources of food.
Winter provides a great opportunity to notice signs of animals, with tracks being among the easiest to find. Though it may be hard to decipher, there are certain clues to notice when observing things like size, location, and gait or walking pattern. Even though Conant Park is a densely populated area, there is plenty of wildlife around, and we can usually find signs even if we don't see the animal itself. These are the tracks of a gray squirrel. Gray squirrels are familiar residents of our parks and neighborhoods. Squirrels eat mostly nuts and seeds, but eat many other plant-based foods as well. In the fall, squirrels are very busy collecting acorns and other nuts that they then bury, usually one at a time. This is their very important food catch for the winter. Gray squirrels remain active all winter and can be seen digging up and eating buried nuts. They locate and dig them up even through deep snow, as seen here.
These are fox tracks. Fox tracks can be confused with the tracks of small dogs, but there are ways to tell them apart. When foxes walk, the hind foot steps perfectly into the front track. This makes the track pattern appear as though there are only 2 feet, looking a lot like the pattern of a human walking. Usually, fox tracks are in a line. Domestic dogs tend to weave back and forth, and all 4 feet are seen in the pattern. These are bird tracks. While we don't know exactly what kind of bird made these tracks, we do know that it was a bird because many birds, especially our small songbirds, have a foot in which 3 toes are pointed forward and 1 is pointed backward. These are the tracks of a white-tailed deer. The print shows 2 toes which, when together, form a heart shape, with the bottom point of the heart pointing the direction in which the deer is traveling. The toes spread out slightly when the deer is walking through deep snow or mud, and spread out even more when the deer is running or bounding. The marks on these trees are called buck rubs. These marks occur when male deer, also known as bucks, rub their antlers against a small tree. They do this usually to mark their territory or to remove the velvet from their antlers. Bucks lose their antlers and regrow them every year. And when they grow back, they are covered in a velvety, soft skin. These tracks are from a common nocturnal animal, which means they are active at night. The raccoon. Raccoon tracks show 5 long toes in both the front and the back feet. They kind of look like tiny human handprints. Raccoons and their tracks are commonly found near water. Beneath this fallen tree, red foxes have dug a den. Red foxes mate in the winter, January or February here in New Jersey, and the pups are born about 50 days later. The female will remain in the den prior to and for a time after giving birth. During this time, the male brings food for the female and leaves it at the den entrance for her. He does not enter the den. The average litter size is 5, but could be as many as 10. Fox young are called kits or pups. The red fox has been able to adapt very well to living in our neighborhoods. Foxes are omnivores. Although we think of them as hunters, eating mice, voles, chipmunks, etc., they also eat plants, including acorns, grass, seeds, and fruits.
There are many places where an animal may make a home or even hide out. These hollow spaces in trees are called cavities. Tree cavities provide an excellent home to many animals of all sizes. from flying squirrels all the way up to raccoons. Should you see a large, messy-looking bunch of leaves and sticks high up in a tree, it is not a bird nest. It's actually a special nest for a squirrel called a dray. Squirrels will pack these drays tightly with leaves, which makes them surprisingly warm. Squirrels are excellent examples of animals that do not hibernate throughout winter. Rather, they adapt. Here we see a squirrel basking in the sun. Sometimes we often see them scurrying across tree limb to tree limb. These animals rely on caches of nuts that they've hidden throughout the fall to sustain them throughout the winter. Within Conan Park, there are even signs of rare migratory visitors, such as the yellow-bellied sapsucker, who only frequents the park for several weeks or possibly only even a few days out of the year. This is a red-tailed hawk, a large common raptor found in many different habitats across New Jersey. Being a raptor means that they hunt and eat other animals. Their favorite food is squirrels. They are commonly seen soaring through the air, using their excellent eyesight to hunt for meals.
Notice how this perched hawk scans its surroundings in search of any prey.
Climbing up this tree, we have a year-round resident, the red-bellied woodpecker. Named for their reddish-pink coloration on their torsos, these woodpeckers have striking white and black barring on their backs and wings. While males will have a red hood on their heads, females will have a red spot on their nape. The red-bellied woodpecker is most often found at backyard feeders or on tree limbs in search of food, but can be also found across a variety of habitats.
This large soaring bird is a turkey vulture. Turkey vultures are common scavengers throughout New Jersey, meaning that they'll only eat things that are already dead, kind of like nature's cleanup crew. Turkey vultures are easy to identify through their flight pattern, often resembling a large wobbly V.
There are many species of trees residing in Conant Park. Walking on both the forested trail and multi-use path, you can have fun finding lots of different kinds of trees. This is an eastern white pine. Pine trees are members of an exclusive group of trees known as evergreens. The name evergreen is appropriate because white pines, like many other conifers, never lose all of their needles and go bare. Since it's able to maintain needles all year long, it makes a great winter home for animals, and its seeded pine cones can provide some nourishment. This is a northern red oak. Red oaks are very large, hardy, fast-growing, and long-lived trees. This acorn-bearing tree is not just important to dozens of species of animals as a food and shelter source, but it's also the state tree of New Jersey. This next tree is an American beech tree. As you can see, there are a lot of leaves still on it, even in the middle of winter. This is because the American beech tree exhibits a trait known as marcescence. This means that it hangs onto its leaves long after the leaves die. This can help you identify beech trees as well as some species of oak trees. Another feature of the American beech tree is its smooth gray bark. While it is beautiful, it's also inviting for people who want to carve into the tree. However, this can have dire consequences for the tree. When visiting Conant Park and any other park, please respect all wildlife, including the trees. Thanks so much for watching our video. We hope that you enjoyed it and are inspired to explore a park near you.